Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. This is first ever video in this channel, so I have to introduce myself. My name is Kanhaiya Patel. I am a student of MSc second semester, and the main purpose to make this channel is whatever I have knowledge about chemistry, I have to discuss with more people. So this is the one of the good platform to discuss with and try to learn new things and just increase my knowledge. So that's why I make this channel, and hope my notes and my efforts will be helpful for other also. So let's move the topic. The first topic is Auger electron spectroscopy, is also referred to as AES. So what is the basic introduction of Auger electron spectroscopy? So basically, Auger electron spectroscopy is one of the important topic of scattering spectroscopy, and it is also very important for semester exam and CSIR NET exam point of view. We have to know about the basic concept of Auger electron spectroscopy. So basic introduction of Auger electron spectroscopy is, Auger electron spectroscopy is a widely used technique to investigate the compositions of surface of solids. So basically, AES is a technique to investigate the compositions of surface of solid. Solid means sample. In Auger electron spectroscopy, we only use the solid form of sample. That's why here it's solid. So first discovered in 1923 by Lise Meitner, and later independently discovered once again in 1925 by Pierre Auger. That's why its name Auger electron spectroscopy, the name from Pierre Auger. Okay, so now the principle of Auger electron spectroscopy is very important. In this video, we are going to discuss the principle point wise and also try to explain the principle from diagram. So first point is, a fine focus electron beam bombard the sample and eject an electron of the inner cell of atom. So basically, this point is tell about electron collision. So what is electron collision? Is electromagnet, this is the atom, and this is atom, and this is the inner cell, and this is electron. So basically, electromagnetic radiation we use in Auger electron spectroscopy process. So electromagnetic radiations, when bombard the electron of inner cell of atom, so the electron will move out from there, and the vacancy will be made. So this vacancy must be refilled by an electron from the higher energy level. So basically, the vacancy will be must refilled by the higher energy level electrons of higher energy level. Okay, when the higher energy electron will fills the vacancy, what happened? When the higher energy electron fills the hole, the release of energy is transferred to an electron in an outer orbit. So basically, when this electron will fall down in this hole, so what happened? The energy kind of energy also released that electron. So the energy is transferred from that electron, outer cell electron. The main thing is that what happened, when electron will fill the hole, the electron also releasing some energy. So that energy will forward to this outer orbit electron. When energy is moved from there, this electron, so what happened? The electron has, okay, that electron. So that electron has sufficient energy to overcome the binding energy and the work function to be ejected with a characteristic kinetic energy. One kind of kinetic energy also work with that electron. So what happened after for the reason of that energy, that electron will out from that atom. So that electron which removed from that atom is called Auger electron. Okay, the ejected electron is referred to as an Auger electron. The Auger process required three electrons. Thus, we cannot detect hydrogen, helium, but can detect all other elements from lithium on up. So basically, what happened? Three electrons will required for this process. That's why we are not going to detect it hydrogen and helium from this process, because hydrogen has one electron and helium has two electrons. That's why we are not going to detect that elements from that process. Okay, this is the main point. So this is the basic principle. I hope you will be understand, and Now, the main important one of the one of important point of that topic is an emitted electron will have a kinetic energy. Emitted electron, in the sense electron, auger electron is auger electron which removed from the atom is has have a kinetic energy of that kinetic energy will just discuss with. We can find out that kinetic energy from that particular formula is E kinetic equal to E core state minus EB minus EC. So that is an important diagram also from that. This is the K cell is inner cell and this vacancy must be refilled as electromagnetic radiation bombarded with that electron. And this is the L1 cell, L2, L3 set. For that diagram, the kinetic energy formula is like that. E kinetic equal to K minus L1 minus L2 3. So that is the main formula of kinetic energy. Okay, so that's the important points of auger electron spectroscopy, important principle of that. Now instrumentation process we are going to discuss. So while we are going to discuss about instrumentation of this process, we have to know about the essential components of that instrument. I think the process of instrumentation is not very important. We have to know only the essential components. So that's why I'm going to discuss the essential components of AES spectrometer. Are first is UHV environment. UHV environment is very important in this instrumentation because UHV environment means it's a ultra high vacuum. Full form is ultra high vacuum environment. So when we are characterized by the when we are going to characterize the ultraviolet high ultra high vacuum, so it's characterized by a pressure lower than 10 to the power minus 8 to 10 to the power minus 12 mbar, and it is common in chemistry. Is very important to scientific research because experiment often require a chemically clean sample surface with the absence of any unwanted absorbance. So that's why ultra high vacuum environment is very important in this instrumentation. Second is electron gun. Electron gun is very important because electron gun is that just bombard the electromagnetic radiation in our target, in our sample. So it is also very essential components, electron gun. And third is electron energy analyzer. Fourth is electron detector, data recording, processing and output system. That's all are very essential components on this instrument. And this is enough to know about the instrumentation of that AES, because I think a process is not that much important for our semester examination and also for any competition examination. And that is a diagram of auger electron spectroscopy instrumentation that have a target, electron gun, sweep supply, optical ion source, shield, electron detector, data acquisitions, and that's an important instrumentation diagram. Now we are going to discuss the application parts of that auger electron spectroscopy. It is very important because application is something which is very useful for any topic. When you get to know the application, that it will be very helpful to you in your examinations. So what is the application of AES? First is surface sensitive. When we are going to define the surface sensitive, is like a surface sensitive technique is more sensitive to those atoms which are located near the surface than it is to atom in the bulk which are well away from the surface. So basically this is the definition of surface sensitive. And second most important application is elemental and chemical composition analysis, analysis by comparison with standard sample of known composition. Third important application is detection of elements heavier than lithium, very good sensitivity for light elements. Depth profiling analysis. So what is depth profiling analysis? One of the very important application of auger electron spectroscopy. So depth profiling is a process where the element or chemical content of a sample is measured as a function of depth. Okay, so many analysis technique that perform depth profiling use a beam of ions such as like a O2 plus and CS plus gallium, and this is the kind of depth profiling analysis. So it is one of the important process for auger electron spectroscopy. And fifth important application is spatial distribution of the element, SEM. So basically SEM and Auger electron spectroscopy are electron beam technique based on the Auger effect. So this is the important application of Auger electron spectroscopy. So limitations is also very important for any topic. So Auger electron spectroscopy has some limitations, that is analyze conducting and semiconducting sample. Special procedure are required for non-conducting samples, and only solid specimens can be analyzed. So basically conducting and semiconducting samples will be also will only analyze, because when we are going to analyze the non-conducting sample, it will be required a new procedure, a special procedure, which is very difficult. So that's why this is the limitations, and only solid specimen can be analyzed. In before I also talked about that solid specimens can be only analyzed by this process. And quantification is not easy. Definitely it is one of the important limitations for that process. And hydrogen and helium are not detectable as they have electron less than 3. Okay, so hydrogen and helium are not hydrogen and helium, the elements are not we are not going to discuss the process of that by using the these elements, because they have a one and two electrons. That's why it is not required, it is not important for that process. And the other elements above the helium is very that would be very important for that process, and that will be used for that process. So that's all the basic limitations of that Auger electron spectroscopy, and that's and this is the handmade notes I provide you and try to explain that. I hope that notes will be helpful for you, and it is and you understood what I try to what I try to just tell you. So I hope these notes will be helpful. For further video, please connect with my channel, and please support, like, share, and subscribe to my channel. And thank you so much for watching.